Hey everybody, welcome back to the Live Violin Challenge. So happy you are here today with me. And first let's start by saying how proud I am on all of you that you are here today, right now, and that you decided to practice the violin today, tonight, Sunday evening. There are so many things you could do, but you are practicing the violin and I'm so proud of you for doing so. And today we are going to practice vibrato as we have been talking about yesterday. But before we start practicing, please tell me from where you are joining us today. I see some names that were joining yesterday too, like Anya, and also some new faces, or at least people that are joining new, maybe Amy. Are you here for the first time today? So let me know if you are joining for the first time today, or if you have been joining yesterday too in the comments. It would be lovely to see. And meanwhile, we're waiting for a few more minutes for the last people to drop in before we can start practicing vibrato today. Thank you so much, Amy. I really appreciate it. Hi from Iraq. Oh, Frank is saying hi. Thomas from USA. Chris is here for the first time. Big thumbs up for you. That's great. Everybody who is practicing two evenings behind each other deserves a pat on the back. And also, if you're here for the first time, I'm so proud of you for being here and showing up and practicing with us. Hi, Penny. Welcome from Louisiana. Hello from India, Sujit. Oh, you've been there yesterday, right? Yeah, great that you are there again. Hi, Nishant. And Lee is here for the first time from Tennessee, USA. Welcome, Lee. Great that you're joining us today. And hi, Dan. Dan has been here yesterday too, I believe. Right, Dan? Welcome to the challenge. Okay, I think we're going to get started right now and just see who still is dropping in. But first, please let me know, how's the audio quality? Is it good right now? Yesterday there was a little trouble with the audio quality, that the people that were here yesterday know that. So please check if your A has the same tuning as mine. Please make a bow stroke on the A string and let me know in the comments if your A sounds the same or if it sounds really different. Good audio now. Oh, that's great to hear. Thank you, Lee and Amy. And hi, Herman from Transylvania. Welcome to the class. And hi, Vaden. Okay, we are going to talk about vibrato today. And that is such an exciting topic because vibrato is like, if you're a violinist, you know that vibrato is like kind of this like creamy, it is like the dessert after dinner. Like it makes everything sound so much more beautiful and creamy, and yeah, couldn't stop talking about vibrato, right? So it's just this amazing technique. But for those of you who are beginner violinists, maybe never heard of vibrato before, so I'm going to quickly demonstrate what vibrato is. So vibrato is actually the technique where you are wiggling with your finger, and this makes the tone sound really vibrant and beautiful. So the best way to demonstrate is to first show a piece without vibrato and then with vibrato and showing you the difference. So let's try. Hi, Stephanie from Los Angeles. Okay, hi, Farah from Syria. Okay, I'm going to show you the difference of vibrato and no vibrato. So let's start with no vibrato. And I'm just going to play a very simple tune like Hallelujah. and you can see the difference. Oh, no vibrato, sorry. Hallelujah without vibrato. Now let's have a look at what it sounds like with vibrato. It sounds so much more expressive and amazing. And hi from Mexico and hi from Egypt. Hi Octavio and Justina, welcome to class. So it sounds so much more bigger, the kind of sounds. And now without. It is amazing, and that is what we are going to learn today. So be really excited to learn this, because it is hard to learn vibrato. Let's start by that. It is hard, but it is so worth it, because it makes it kind of helps you to get rid of the kind of beginner feel and really get into this more like advanced sounding spectrum, intermediate advanced player. So that's really exciting to feel like for the first time it really starts to sound kind of professional in a way. And that is the cool thing about vibrato. Now, I'm talking too much about vibrato. We should practice, right? Let's practice. So all get your violin. And while you're getting your violin, I'm talking about one more thing. And that is the most biggest problem I actually see with violinists that are practicing the violin online, because many of you don't have a teacher and some do, but the problem is that very many people would like to learn vibrato in one lesson. And if that is your goal, to learn vibrato right now in this lesson and be able to do it after the lesson, I have to disappoint you, because it is impossible to learn vibrato in just one lesson. But don't leave when I'm telling this. This is not a bad thing. This is actually a good thing. Because often the things that are most beautiful in life are things you have worked for, or things you put time into, you know? Like the best relationships are with the most amazing people are the relationships you put time in. And it's the same for vibrato. You have to give it some time. You have to give it some attention, and then it will come to you. So it takes time to develop vibrato, and it is, and almost all violinists I know, hi Simon, and all violinists I know took time to develop it. Nobody just got it in one lesson. So now this misconception is out of the way, and we know that we won't learn it in one lesson. What can we do to develop vibrato over time, and maybe over months of time? And I know it needs patience. And that is one of the most important things and teachings I want to give you today, actually, is to take that time and not feel like you are not a good violinist just because you didn't master vibrato yet. Because some are like, oh my God, I've been practicing for so many months. Maybe it's not in, I just don't have it in me to become a violin player. And that is so not true. It is completely possible for any person to learn vibrato if you are willing to put the time and effort into it. So if you are in this phase right now where you are doubting if you are able to learn vibrato, I want to tell you that the highest possibility is that you absolutely can. There are some really, like, sometimes if you have a specific illness in your fingers, it can actually become difficult, but if you don't have that, you can learn it. So how do you learn it? Let's get started right now, and I'm going to show you a routine that you can do every day, and that if you do this really, like, often, you will learn vibrato in the end. So first, we get started by putting our violin on our shoulders. And for now, hi from Belgium. Hi, welcome Elodie. We are putting the bow away for a moment. And we are just going to make this motion with our hands. I know it looks a little bit flaky on camera right now, but let's just do it together. Okay, so you're shaking your head and try to relax your hand as much as possible. One of the most important things for learning vibrato is actually relaxing your hand and feeling really relaxed. And that is also so frustrating for many of us because we're all like, how can I relax when playing the violin? It's so difficult. And then I also have to relax. It can be so frustrating if you're just starting out. So try to relax your hand as much as you can. Hi, Joseph, welcome to lesson. And try to relax your hand. And now put it on the strings. And now we are going to do a little exercise. You put your third finger, that will be the ring finger, you will put that on the string. The other fingers can kind of be loosely, either on the string or a little bit above the string. And you're going to slowly wipe the string. This is a small warm-up we are doing to kind of get into the right movement of vibrato. So you're just doing this. Join us doing this right now. If you don't have your violin yet, grab it really quickly. You can still join for the exercises. Okay. So we're swiping up and down, just like you're cleaning your strings. Hi, Anna, welcome. Okay, cleaning our strings. And try to keep it really relaxed. And I know you always need some tension, right? Because otherwise your hand would just fall flat down. So use the minimum amount of tension to make this movement. And now we're going to make this movement smaller. And now bigger again. Make it a little bit bigger. Don't let the boringness of this exercise deceive you, by the way. I know that sometimes it's like, oh my God, Julia, this is so boring. Why are we doing this? Okay, I'm going to watch cat videos now. Don't go. Don't leave. Practice with me, because each time you practice vibrato is one step in the right direction. Each time you practice vibrato is one step in the direction of becoming really good at violin playing. So right now, this was our first exercise. Now we are going to do our second vibrato exercise, which is getting loose fingers. So what I want you to do is to put your violin away for one moment. And you're just going to make this motion. So you're kind of like pushing through your knuckle over here. And you try to do it with as much relaxation as possible. And also, if you're not able to do it as quickly as I do right now, do it very slowly. Take your time. Do it as slow as you need to do it. I'm going to show it very closely so you can see it. Do you see? This is the movement you're making. So kind of pushing through the knuckle. And we are now going to do that on each finger. And meanwhile, I'm welcoming Dario from Italy, Diego from not sure, and Imelten from Turkey. Welcome to lesson. Guys, be sure to do these exercises with me right now, because each time you practice this, will be one step in the direction to learn vibrato. And you're going to be so happy and so proud if you've learned that. So do this right now. And okay, that were our few warm-up exercises. So we're kind of warming up our hands. Now do this again. One time more. Not sure. Just act like a crazy person, basically. It will be a great way to practice vibrato. Okay, more people from Turkey coming in. You can still join the exercises, guys. Okay, first step accomplished. We have warmed up our hands. So this is what you do before you are starting practice vibrato. You're just going to kind of warm up. You're kind of making the motion, going through these motions, kind of warming up your knuckles, your fingers, so they feel warm and relaxed. And now we are getting started with one of the most exciting vibrato exercises. And this is kind of the basic exercise. And if you are able to do this exercise, you can learn vibrato. This is kind of the basic vibrato motion. And this exercise is called slow motion vibrato. This is how I call it. So we are going to practice this right now. And meanwhile, the lesson already starts. So no 5 minutes left anymore. Okay. So motion vibrato works like this. Okay, get your violin, guys, right now. Get your violin. If you are watching this without your violin, by the way, you need to get it right now. I promise you, you will really, really benefit from practicing with us right now. And it will be so much more fun if you get your violin. So get it really quickly and come back to your computer. So, okay, we start by placing our third finger on the A string. And this exercise, by the way, is rather difficult. So don't worry if you don't get it right away, and maybe even don't get it in this class. Just try, just bear with me, try it, and just take your time to learn it. Okay, let's try. Hi, Elizabeth, welcome to lesson. Okay, so let's start right now by doing the exercise. Slow motion vibrato works in this way. I'm going to show it to you once and then I'm going to explain it. That sounds horrible, right? Don't worry about it. That's normal. It sounds horrible in the beginning, but this is an awesome exercise. Don't let the way it sounds deceive you in thinking it's not an awesome exercise, because it is. It's going to change your life. Serious, guys. This is changing your life if you're a violinist. I can speak from experience. My students have learned it with this exercise alone. There are students that I have that learned vibrato just with this exercise. So you're placing your third finger on the A string. I'm going to come as close to the camera as possible so you can see me. And then you are making this motion, playing the third finger. And then you are moving your hand backwards. So actually the third finger will sound a little lower. It is kind of like your hand is just relaxing downwards. And when you do this, you should try to make it by the way, I see a comment coming in. You should put an extra micro. Is the sound quality still good? Let me know if there's any trouble and if I can do anything. Improve. Okay. Oh, Ruba, I'm so proud. I'm so proud that you're still practicing violin, even though it's 10 at your place. Okay, we are going to practice right now again. So you're placing your third finger on the string, moving it backwards and forwards again. Try it yourself right now. Three, back, and three. Three, back, three. Try to play along. Three, back, three. Three, back, three. Three, back, three. How is this coming along? How is it going, guys? Let me know in the comments how this is going for you. Now, there are two ways on which you can go about going back and forth on one note. And these are also the two kinds of vibrato. I'm happy that the audio is still good. Welcome, Kaylee and Ali. I'm happy you're there. And Annette. Okay, there's two ways in which you can make the vibrato motion. And this is also violinist. Actually divides vibrato in two kinds of vibratos. Maybe one of you has already heard of one of the kinds of vibrato. Let me know in the comments. Does anybody know already about the kinds of vibrato? There's two kinds of vibrato. I'm waiting for a few seconds to see if anybody of you already knows. So let me know in the comments, which kind of vibratos are there? How can you make the vibrato motion? Two kind of body parts, I could say, that could make the vibrato motion. I see no comments coming in so far. I'm sorry if that's just because of my internet connection, so I'm going to show it to you right now. Okay, there are two kinds of vibrato. The first kind of vibrato is arm vibrato. And the second kind of vibrato, one arm vibrato, the second kind of vibrato is wrist vibrato. So these are the two kinds of vibrato. Arm vibrato and wrist vibrato. And actually, oh my god, there were already people guessing it right. I'm so proud of you. I just see your comments coming in right now. Great. Okay, so actually some of you guys already knew this. Wrist vibrato and arm vibrato. So there's a difference between those two kinds of vibrato, but they can actually also be mixed. So some violin players use both vibratos at the same time. Now I'm going to show you the difference right now for those who didn't hear about it yet. So wrist vibrato is where you make this slow motion vibrato motion that we've just been making, where you are making this from the wrist. And actually the term wrist vibrato is a little deceiving, because where you've actually make it from your hands. The muscles in your hand pull the finger backwards and push it forward again. So wrist vibrato is actually coming from your hand. So technically you would probably have to call it hand vibrato, but violinists are not very logical sometimes. They are too emotional. They were like, oh, it's my wrist, it's coming from my wrist, whatever. So wrist vibrato, you are actually making this backwards motion from your wrist. If you are talking about arm vibrato, you are making this motion from your arm. So, do you see how my whole forearm was just going back and forth and my wrist stayed kind of in one place? So, and wrist vibrato, back and forth with wrist or back and forth with the whole arm. Now, some violinists actually kind of combine the two. They are using both at the same time. You have to check right now what feels best for you, because it's different for everybody. And you just have to check right now what makes you feel more relaxed. Pulling the finger back with the arm or with the wrist. Let me know in the comments. And let me know if it works out in general. I would really love to hear if this is difficult for you or that it actually works pretty well, because this exercise can be pretty difficult. So slow motion vibrato. Okay, so try out the two vibratos, wrist and arm. Try it out, what works best for you, and let me know in the comments. Hi, Atalia, welcome to class. So, still waiting for comments coming in. Meanwhile, I'm going to show you the exercise we are going to do after that. While I'm waiting for your comments to come in, if wrist or arm vibrato was easiest for you, let me know. So for now, just go with the vibrato that feels more comfortable. You can always learn the other kind of vibrato after. So meanwhile, the comments are already coming in. For Diego says, for me, it's almost impossible. I so understand, Diego. It makes so much sense. It's so difficult in the beginning. And Stephanie says that wrist is easier. And Anya, too. For Dan, wrist vibrato is easier. And Ali says, everything is really stiff. I'm going to give you some exercises in a moment you can do when it is too stiff. And Amy doesn't know yet. Actually, there's one little thing you can try to see if wrist or arm vibrato works the best for you. It is, you can get, do you know these kind of eggs? And there's some like little, it's like a little instrument and it looks like an egg. And if you move it like that, it's making a sound. And some people are naturally moving it with their arm and other people are naturally moving it with their wrist. You can actually try to get something, like maybe you can even use like some herbs from the kitchen and try what works best for you with your wrist, what you naturally use, your wrist or your arm. And if you can't choose, I would always go for wrist, because wrist vibrato is easier to not make any mistakes when you're practicing with wrist vibrato and to keep your hand relaxed. Because if you are playing arm vibrato, it is a little easier to get stiff and still play kind of vibrato, but not the right kind of vibrato. So if you can choose, go for wrist right now and try to pull your finger back with your wrist. But you can also go for arm, and you can go for the combination. Actually, my vibrato is also a combination of the two. Now, maybe your hand doesn't even want to go back or doesn't want to get pulled back. And it might be the case that you are actually holding onto the instrument too much. So normal violin position is like this. Do you see how the finger is kind of touching the fingerboard? Do you see that over here? It's touching it. And this is how most students learn to play violin, which is a great way to feel very secure. But if you are playing vibrato, you actually have to release your hands a little bit. It's going to move away from the spot. So you have to feel okay with moving your hand backwards, and that this part is not kind of attaching to the violin. Also, the thumb should be a little bit flexible, so it stays more or less at the same place, but it is no problem if it moves a little bit. If you're, and Kelly says that wrist vibrato is easier, but her violin moves along. If your violin moves along when you try to play vibrato, you are pushing too much into the violin with your thumb. And you should try to release your thumb even more. You can also try to release your finger over here even more if you are touching with the finger. But normally for my students, it's the thumb. So Bowen says, how can I learn vibrato? Okay, so how do you learn vibrato? You have to do this slow motion vibrato exercise, but don't just do this exercise. You have to get faster at it over time. So it is kind of progressive, a progressive exercise. It's like going to the gym. You don't start using bench pressing 100 kilos at once. You start with a lower amount and then you kind of ramp it up over time. So I'm going to show you what it could look like. So first, you play vibrato this slowly. And if you've learned this in this tempo, you are going to try to play it faster. Until you can play it as fast as real vibrato. And to actually play it, so you need to learn to play it faster over time. So how do you go about that? First, you need to learn basic motion. So keep practicing while I'm talking. Don't mind me, you need to practice right now. So keep practicing while I'm talking about vibrato and keep trying this. The first thing you need to learn is just to make this motion. And this is difficult on itself. It is so difficult to make this motion correct, because just like you've been talking about, the violin starts moving along, you feel like your whole hand gets stiff. And the only way to learn this is to try it all the time, every day, and not too long. Don't do it for 10 or 20 minutes. Just do it for 5 minutes, or maybe even 2 minutes before you start your practice. Vibrato is the best learned if you practice it a little bit every single day, instead of like practicing a lot and then not practicing it anymore. So really make sure to, So now we are going to use, actually, Diego says, how about using the metronome? And that's exactly what we are going to do right now. So I'm going to show you what vibrato practice will look like, and you can practice along right now. So I see that the comment gets liked that says the violin moves along. So if your violin moves along, you have to try to relax your thumb and your fingers even more. So make sure to release your thumb. Your thumb is pressing into the fingerboard. That's what's happening, probably. So now I put my metronome on 60 BPM. People have been asking yesterday, what metronome do I use? This is metronome beats, but actually I prefer to use stage metronome. I use this one right now because it has a nicer sound for this lesson. So we are going to try to play vibrato as fast as this metronome goes right now. And three and back. Okay, now let's try to play it a little faster. Now I'm going to bump it up to 80. And again, if you can't join right now, if this is going too fast, just do it in your own tempo. This is just to show you kind of the scope in which you can practice from fast, from slow to faster. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And follow along right now. Try to play along. Okay, now we're going to play it faster. I see some new people coming in. If you just came into this video, make sure to get your violin. Don't watch this without your violin. Practice along right now. This can really change your vibrato for the better. You can learn to play vibrato better just in this lesson. So make sure to get your violin right now and join us. Okay, I have a hard time keeping my bow going in the same direction while practicing vibrato. This question is coming in from Carol. And yeah, I definitely know this problem. Actually, it might help you to practice slurs. If you don't know what slurs is that you play several notes on one bow stroke. So do you see how the bow is just going in one direction? So you really have to be kind of good at slurs already to practice vibrato. So I really recommend, if the slurs are difficult, to practice slurs first. And if that is not a problem, if you are actually already good at slurs, you can also practice this. We are going to do this right now together. So everybody, move your hands right now on the string. So you're going to just like kind of make this motion and not touch any strings, just touch the fingerboard and make your hands wave at yourself. So you're waving at yourself, and now you are going to play just the A. Do you notice how difficult that is to not play it with any bumps? And this is kind of the curse of being a human, I think, that our hands want to do the same thing. So on the moment you start doing this with the left hand, your bow hand also wants to start doing this, right? So then this kind of stuff happens. So you can practice this actually to get better at playing in the same bow direction and kind of keeping the bow going solid while you are practicing your vibrato. So you actually can do this exercise by waving at yourself and just playing with the bow just on one string, so you can actually hear if it sounds good. Okay, so we are going to continue our practice. We stopped at 80 BPM. Now we're going to try to play it a little faster. Meanwhile, keep practicing your slow motion vibrato. If anything I say doesn't help you, just practice. Okay, so now we are going to try it at 100. So it's going to be this beat. Let's try it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. Three back. Switch bow direction. Three back. So make sure to play three back. And then go in the other bow direction. Three back on the down bow, and three back on the up bow. So the back motion and the back, with back I mean just this back motion. So going back downwards. So we are going to go a little faster once more. And this is how you will actually practice it at home too. All the time you try to go a little faster. And if you can't go faster right now, don't go faster. It's better to practice slower and to really try to relax your head than to go too fast. But for now, I'm just going to show you how it could look like if you could go faster right now. What it could look like. So one, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Three back, three back, three back, three back, three back. Okay, one time you're going a little faster. 140, 150, let's try. If that doesn't work out for you, don't worry. It's just to show you how it will look like, how your learning curve will look like. One, two, three, four. So you might be wondering by this time, why are we playing on the third finger all the time? Why? Why are we just doing it on A3? Now actually this is because this is the finger where most of my students get vibrato for the first time. It is the easiest finger to play vibrato on. But because I just want to cover kind of the whole learning plan for vibrato in this video, so you can actually really start learning and have everything you need after this lesson to learn vibrato, I'm going to show you what you can do to practice the other fingers. But I do recommend to first start practicing the third finger, just the third finger, because it is better to learn it on one finger than to not learn it on all fingers, you know? And normally it is like this, if you get it on one finger, it gets much easier on all the other fingers. Okay. Anja says it works. Yes, good luck. It's really great that it works right now for you. If you just get the slow motion vibrato really slowly right now, if you just manage to do T, that is already big progress, big progress. You can be so proud of yourself if you just make a very slow motion vibrato, because that already, then if you can do that, you can do it faster. You just have to practice more and do it more often, but in the end you will learn it. So actually this is amazing if you've learned it so far. So keep practicing while I'm writing the new exercise down for you. So I'm going to write down a new vibrato exercise. Keep trying slow motion vibrato right now. Practice. Keep practicing, guys. Okay, three. Okay, so we are going to play three, and I'm going to make a sign for vibrato. Actually, the sign I use is, what can you see on the screen? This round sign means that you have to put your finger back. So it is three, back, three, back, just like we've done before. Then we are playing two, back, two, two, back. Then we're playing one, one back, one, one back. If you're just dropping in without the violin, make sure to get your violin right now, because we're going to get started with the second exercise and you can still join practicing your vibrato today and getting better at vibrato today. So, really proud of you, everybody that sticks around on a Sunday evening practicing vibrato. I know practicing vibrato is one of the most tedious things to practice because it sounds like an ambulance, and that's not really what we started to play violin for, right? But I promise you, you will get really cool results and it will be so rewarding if you learn vibrato. I was so happy when I learned it for the first time. So we are going to play three, back, two, back, two, back. We are going to play a high two on the A string. One, back, all on the A string. Remember guys, all on the A string. So three, back, two, three, two back, three back, one back, and then we are starting with three again. Okay, okay, I'm going to make a little change in the exercise to make it a little bit better. Forget something. We are going to play three back, three back, three. That's much better. So, two back, two back, two, one back, one back, one. And in the end, we are just going to play an open A string. Does it make sense for you guys? Does it make sense? So, we are playing D, and then a little bit pulling your finger away from the D. D, going backwards from the D. And then C sharp. And then one. And A. So, in total, the exercise will look like this. Try it. Together. So three back, three back, three. This is going to be a down bow. Three back, and up bow. Up bow, three. Two back, three back, up bow, two. One back, up bow, one. And then open A string. Okay, let's try that together once more. One, two, three, four. Three back, three back, three. Two back, two. Two, three, four. One back. One, two, three, four. A, two, three, four. So that is the exercise you are going to do afterwards. So right now I see we are already almost ending our lesson because it's already 45 minutes has already passed since the starting of the lesson. And I have an important announcement to make for the next lessons that will be happening. Because first of all, I'm so proud of you for sticking around during this lesson. It's amazing that you are here. We are going to practice vibrato once more in the end. First, I'm going to make a short announcement. Okay, so tomorrow there will be another lesson happening. It will be at the same time as this lesson, and it is also on this Facebook page. So if you want to join there, put it in your calendar right now. 20 GMT plus one, or 8 p.m. GMT plus one. That's kind of the German way of saying that. I'm going to put it in the English way. 8 GMT plus one. Tomorrow we are going to talk about finger speed and we are going to talk about how to play faster. Because there's this common misconception that if you can play it slow, you can play it fast. My teacher used to tell me that. It's like, if you can play it slow, you can play it fast. And I was like, okay, I will play slow all the time. And then I tried to play it fast and it was so slow, you know. So I'm going to show you how you can actually learn to play fast tomorrow. And yeah. It will be so useful, our lesson tomorrow, and I really hope you want to be a part of it too. It's really amazing with you guys. So this lesson will be tomorrow. Next week, in during the weekend, on Saturday and Sunday, there will be two workshops taking place. The first workshop on Saturday will be a beginner workshop. Again, all these lessons are free. You can just join if you have a computer. Saturday, there will be a beginner workshop. On which date is it? The 10th of November. And Sunday, there is an intermediate workshop taking place at the 11th of November. If you've been playing for less than a year, you have to join the beginner workshop. If you've been playing between 1 and 2 years, you're kind of in between. I think if you have been practicing a lot, go to the intermediate. If you not have been practicing a lot, go to the beginner. And more than 2 years, go to the intermediate workshop. That will be a lot of fun too, and I'm going to give even more thorough explanation of how you can get from a beginner. In a beginner workshop, I'm going to explain how you can get from a beginner to an intermediate level, and I'm going to show you all the steps you need to take to get to the next level. In the intermediate workshop, I'm going to teach how you can get from an intermediate level to an advanced level of playing. In the intermediate workshop, we're mostly talking about positions, vibrato, learning like to play in higher positions. In the beginning workshop, we are mostly talking about really creating beautiful tone, getting really good bow control, and learning to play in tune well in first position, and how to go about all of that. I'm going to explain it in extreme detail in the workshop. So yeah, I'm so thankful for everybody that showed up. I want to say that to you. I'm so happy that even though we live on the other side of the world, some of you are actually from Germany, which is also amazing that you joined, and some of you are joining from so far away, and I can't tell you how amazing that is for me to be able to communicate with you guys, and that you are taking lessons with me right now. It is just kind of like, not sure how to say that in English. It goes above my head. It's really amazing, and I'm so, so glad that you are here with me and trusting me and taking lessons from me. And I want to do everything to help you. So if there's anything I can do from you, always let me know. I want to help you succeed and learn the violin the best I can online. So, okay. So actually some really kind comments are coming in from Amy. So thankful you're doing more video tutorials. Thank you, Amy. And thank you, Brenda. That's so kind. You're so sweet. Like, everybody's sending really sweet messages. Danke, even in German. Yes, well, really great. Thank you so much, Bowen, Lucy, from somebody from Iraq. I can't tell your name because it's in very difficult letters for me. Thank you, Thomas, for being here. Amy, Stephanie, Liberina. Thank you, Velan. Thank you, Vishnu and Joseph. So happy you are here with me today. Okay, so be sure to join me tomorrow if you have time to practice the violin. You can never practice enough, right? So practice again with me tomorrow. I would be really glad to have you tomorrow. And also be sure to already put the dates in your calendar for next week, Saturday and Sunday. And it will be at the same time again as this lesson. So it will be 8 GMT plus 1. So Saturday and Sunday are the beginner and intermediate workshops. And of course, feel free to join both. If you are a beginner, you can always join the intermediate workshop too and just get inspired by what kind of lays ahead of you and what you will learn in the future. And as an intermediate player, it also makes sense to go over the basics sometimes. Thank you, Nishant and Dan Klein and Kirsten Weaver and Don Jones and Lee Blumenthal and Ali Michael and Carol Majuk, Edward Diego, and Joe just joined. Sorry, we're a little late. Lesson just ended, but you can still watch the replay, and I'm happy you are joining for the last moment. So yeah, so happy you're here with me. Before we end the lesson, we are going to practice vibrato one time more. Get your violin. We are going to practice the difficult. Oh no, the vibrato exercise is gone. So sorry. We are going to practice the difficult vibrato exercise once more. So get your violin for the last time. And once more, we are playing. If your husband is already really angry or your wife, you can also leave it. I know this is not the best exercise, but okay, let's do it for one time more. One, two, okay, we are starting on three, then on two, then on one and zero, right? Okay, one, two, three, four. Three, back, three, back, three, two, three, four. Two, back, two, back, two, three, three, four. One, back. Now, guys, you have to promise me to keep practicing this every single day. Don't give up, even if it takes months. It is very normal that it takes months. Sometimes in the internet age, we feel like you should just click a button and you should be able to get it. But with violin, it's just not the case. It's a very difficult instrument, and I know nobody that is able to play the violin that didn't put a lot of time and effort in it and years of practice. So you are able to do this, and I'm here to support you. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and keep motivated to practice. If you are not yet, I also have motivation emails that I send up about weekly. I try to do it almost every week, where I kind of try to inspire you to practice and send you videos and practice materials. So if you didn't sign up yet, go to my website, violinspiration.com, to sign up for the emails. There I will also give you the invites to all the workshops and all the live lessons that are happening. So it really makes sense to sign up if you are enjoying these kind of lessons. Thank you, Stephanie. And yeah, okay. I'm going to leave you right now, but I'm going to be back tomorrow. So we'll be really happy to see you again tomorrow. Let me know in the comments if you're going to join tomorrow again. Do it. You can do this. We are going to practice 3 times in a row. I'm so proud of you for being here today. I'm so proud of you for being here for the 2nd time already. And I'm so proud of you for joining for 1 time. I'm so proud of you for practicing tonight with me or afternoon. Not sure what time it is in your country. Thank you so much. See you again tomorrow, hopefully. Thank you. Goodbye.